Hello students, today we'll be discussing one of the topics that is very widely discussed in the field of digital media, and that is digital divide. The definition of digital divide is thus. Digital divide basically refers to the gap in the population. Digital divide basically refers to the gap in the population of people who can access and utilize digital media effectively and the people who cannot for whatever reasons. Digital divide is a concept that has to be understood by every citizen of India because there are a couple of reasons that I can list out. The first reason is in order to maintain paced development in the country. Digital media is one of the platforms which has ensured technological advancement in the country at a very rapid pace. If there is a part of the population in the country which has absolutely no access to digital media, it means that that part of the population is left behind in the pace of development of the country. In order to bridge that gap and ensure that the entire population is a part of the developmental phase, we have to understand the gap between the population that can and cannot effectively use digital media. The second importance of understanding digital divide is in order to maintain better governance in the country. The government can only ensure that the most activities take place easier and faster with digital access. For this, digital divide needs to be studied and dealt with in order to ensure that every part of the country and every citizen of the country receives the kind of information and the facilities provided by the government through the digital means. The next importance of understanding digital divide is basically to provide equal exposure to every citizen in the country. The entire population deserves equal exposure to news, education, and expression. Digital platforms are the best way to provide all these three. If we understand digital divide better, these three factors can be fulfilled better, and every part of the population can be provided equal opportunities when it comes to expression, news, and information. Next, we will understand the causes of digital divide in India. The first cause is illiteracy, which is basically lack of education, which causes digital divide because illiterate people or lesser educated people are not aware of the technology that they can utilize and are unaware of the methods through which they can utilize this technology for their benefit. Illiteracy in India is one of the biggest problems which is causing digital divide. The second reason for digital divide is basically poverty. If there is a part of the population which cannot afford new technology, if they cannot afford to buy computers, if they cannot afford to buy cell phones or even hire help which can help them to utilize the technology, it means that they are making way for digital divide. Poverty is another reason in India which has caused digital divide and kept a part of the population out of the progress pace. The third cause for digital divide is basically lack of awareness. Most people do not read or do not know about the newest developments in technology. When they don't know, they don't use, which causes digital divide. In order to tackle this problem, the government has been initiating a number of projects which provides people awareness about the newest technologies available. This problem is being very effectively dealt with, but still, lack of awareness has been and is a very major problem which has been causing digital divide in India. The fourth reason for causes in digital divide is infrastructure. Not all villages and towns in India are equipped with towers or other infrastructure needed for digital access. Rural areas in India are the biggest elements which have been causing digital divide in the country. That is because of the lack of infrastructure which provides the technological assistance required in rural areas. This has been a major problem which is being dealt with effectively, but stands as a challenge nonetheless. The next problem can be climate, which means climatic conditions such as too much temperature or too much cold can also pose a threat to digitization. Though not a major problem in the country, climate has been like in areas of Kashmir or where there have been too much heat, digital divide is seen to be a major problem. The next problem has been the prices of internet, which comes as a subcategory of poverty, which means that internet prices are too high and not the entire population is capable of accessing it owing to the high prices. Also, some problems such as governmental regulations, such as the government prohibiting some forms of digital access for security reasons or such related reasons, have also been reasons for digital divide in India. And lastly, India also tackles with problems such as mindset issues, which some people are not just comfortable utilizing newer technologies and stick to traditional methods of pen and paper while performing their tasks. This mindset issues keeps people away from technology and easier way of doing things, which is also a major problem causing digital divide in the country. Now, there have been a couple of initiatives by the government of India, which has been trying to bridge the digital divide in India. These projects have been successful so far, and the major ones. Firstly, the program is called Gyanadoot, which is a government-to-citizen intranet-based service, which is implemented in the Dhar district of Madhya Pradesh in India, which was implemented in 2000. This project was designed to extend the benefits of information technology to the people in the rural areas by directly linking government and villages through information kiosks. These kiosks are implemented in every village of India, and they provide access to a variety of government services such as registration of complaints and submission of applications for the issuance of certificates and loans. Secondly, Kisan Call Center, which was launched on the 21st of January 2004. The ambition of this scheme is to answer the questions of the farmers, whatever it might be, in their own native language. Third initiative by the government of India is TDIL, which stands for Technology Development for Indian Languages Program, which was established with the objective of developing information processing tools and techniques to facilitate human-machine interaction without language barrier. Like the Kisan Call Center, TDIL also answers questions of people in their own native languages, bridging the digital divide in India. Another project to bridge the digital divide in India by the government of India is Digital Library Project, known as the National Digital Library, which is a massive online library available for anybody to access. This library consolidates educational materials from primary to post-graduation levels. Last project undertaken by the government of India is the Bhoomi project, which was specifically designed for Karnataka in order to digitize the paper land records and create a software mechanism to control changes to the land registry in Karnataka. These initiatives by the government of India have been successful in bridging the digital divide in India to a very large extent. In rural areas, people are made familiar with digital initiatives by the government and are compelled to utilize them, forgoing the traditional pen and paper methods and making all the tasks fast and more efficient. Bridging digital divide in India ensures that the entire population of the country stays in pace with the development of the nation. Thank you.